Well, this was about the learning curve and how to go beyond the hype with blockchain and AI technology. So both blockchain and AI are like just two hype words. So I prefer to use machine learning and distributed ledger technology. So essentially what I said then is, my opinion is we are now at this adoption phase. And adoption doesn't mean that everyone learns about crypto. It means that everyone doesn't need to know about crypto. That people will stop seeing what is blockchain technology and they will just use new, awesome, useful technology. So my take is, and this is what I said to everyone, is once we won't talk about Bitcoin or blockchain, this is the day where it's going to be adopted everywhere.
But with the development that we saw with quantum computing, how do you see that integrated with the blockchain? And how do you see blockchain is going to evolve, bearing in mind this progress with quantum?
Well, I'm not a believer of this quantum supremacy thing. There is very, very easy way to cheat that. So for now, everyone is focusing on SSL, you know, on SHA-256 and how we could eventually break encryption keys. But nobody is really talking about differential security. And differential security is the art of adding noise that cannot be guessed into something and just sharing a way to unguess this. Once you have that, it's not mathematical. It could be atmospheric noise in the sky. It could be stock market things that are happening. It's something that cannot be guessed. So quantum computer would have a nice time trying to guess that one. So I believe that quantum is an overhyped menace that is there to scare people off. But if someone would be able to break quantum for now, with break SSL, there will be no more bank, there will be no more HTTPS, and obviously there will be no more bitcoins because someone could just take it all. It could just break all the keys. Go take the 1 million bitcoin of Satoshi.
So as you are working via partners, organization in order to put together a blockchain architecture, let's say, that is actually going to make money. Is your plan to work with a more public body?
What do you mean, like government?
Yes, because one of the things that came out from the conversation that is basically this paradigm shift is actually going to be pushed by public body. So it won't come, as there was some people say that it won't actually come from the private sector, but would be the big push will come from public body.
I really believe so too. It's already started. As you can know, in China, they already released their own cryptocurrency. They have cashless payments with your face, and they have social credit score. So already a big country understood that they could control their whole population with the art of where you spend, what you can spend it on, and what can you do in your life. Because once you cannot spend money, you cannot do anything in your life. You're a prisoner of the society. And so I believe that governments start to understand that crypto and cryptocurrency or blockchain technology is, as a matter of fact, the best tool. Another example, if we were to add a sovereign, let's say Canadian money, how could you escape your tax? How could you even think about escaping your tax as the regulator would see everything? So there will be a small application that will be just telling, hey, you're sending to Cayman. So now, okay, please pay your tax. So eventually, it's the government body that's going to be the best promoter of this. And I think that most of the regulators have understood this a few years ago. They're just trying to get back at it and hold on this crazy token, the token craziness. People wanted to make quick money, but we are shifting from quick money to real usage, to the fact that blockchain technology is probably the next way of doing social consensus, either on voting, either on banking, either on regulation, either on your private life, either on your medical record. It could be everywhere.
Exactly. So talking about medical, you are based in Canada, so I guess you will be obviously discussing this with some Canadian body. And also you have been to the Medicinal Cannabis Conference. So are you kind of looking, first question, are you kind of looking at the medicinal cannabis market as a way where you can plug the blockchain architecture? And then are you, what's the development on your talks with Canada?
Well, there's a good new project. I've been in touch with a good project called Zenape, which is a very big supply chain and payment provider related to cannabis. I think that the whole cannabis thing is a bit past now. So the opportunity was like last year. So now the opportunity is a bit like, you remember the gold digger time? There was all people going to rush the gold. But who did really make money? There's the one who sold the tools. So I think that the next big opportunity for now in cannabis is how can we create useful tools for people to either consume, either have their needs done, and it's around the industry that is important for now. Going into cannabis is losing money for now.
Okay, what about Canadian public bodies?
Well, I've been working with the OSC like 4 years ago. They were already aware of what was happening, and they were doing hackathon all the way over to understand how a regulator could use blockchain technology. At that point, they understood about the timestamping, about the immutability, and now it has evolved a lot with smart contract and everything. We can go much more further, and they are already thinking about how they're going to install a regulated body that will be able to know everything about your finance. They are already thinking about how can we harmonize all these files that are everywhere, because in Canada it's a hellhole. All your medical file, all your education file, all your government and financial file, they're all spread everywhere. They're losing it all the time, they're getting hacked all the time. So how can we protect citizens at the same time, making it more efficient? Well, I think that distributed ledger technology is one of these answers. And it's not with a token.
Thank you.